Second.
Yes.
Okay, hello students. Today we are going to demonstrate one of the important experiment of chemistry. That is the heat of neutralization. So basically, we all are aware of that. What is a neutralization reaction? When acid and bases they react, we get a salt and water, and that time some amount of energy is being released in the atmosphere. That energy, the heat energy that we have to measure. So the main aim of this experiment is that to determine the enthalpy of neutralization of a strong acid and strong base. So we have two solutions which would be given in the exam. This is the Stokes solution. This is the HCl we have, and the second one we have a NMH. So both are 0.5 molar HCl and NMH. So how to perform this experiment? This is very important part. So the apparatus, what is needed for this experiment? We have, these are the two different cylinders are there. The name is already like written over there, HCl and NMH. So what we are going to do for the first step, this is the thermometer that we have, okay, for measuring the temperature. So the first step would be what? First we have to take the HCl in the HCl cylinder. And how much it is given in the in your manual? That is the 50 ml. 50 ml of HCl. Okay. So as you can see, 50 ml. If it is bit excess, so you can remove it. So 50 ml lower meniscus, I have taken the HCl. Okay, now this 50 ml of HCl I am going to transfer in this polythene bottle. Okay, and I am going to measure the temperature of this HCl. So it is better to wash the thermometer with the help of water, avoiding any contamination. So I am just putting over here. Now as you can see the thermometer also, there is a red mark, you can see red lining. So immediately it should be dipped in the HCl ka solution, HCl that solution, you can see it should be, thermometer should be dipped in the HCl solution, and we can see the temperature. It is 29.5. okay, this is 29.5. Can see the red mark. So this is 29.5. Okay, so this one is a 29.5. Now what I'm doing, I'm washing this thermometer in water, because I have to take the temperature of NMH also in the same way. So I'm keeping aside, I'm taking now NMH. NMH, how much? 50 ml. Okay, so I'm taking 50 ml. Same way, I'm transferring in the NMH a polythene bottle. Okay, and then again, I'm measuring the temperature of NMH. So this temperature is my T2. Initially which I taken, that is T1 HCl ka. Okay, so we have to wait at least 1 minute. That is rising, you can see here this is 28, 3 is there, that is a 30 ka hai. Uske niche you can see that 28 29 29.1. This is also 29.5. fire. So 29.5. So both are I'm getting 29.5 T1 as well as T2. So what is a T1? T1 is the temperature of HCl and T2 is the temperature of, that is the T2. Okay. That is the NaOH. T2 is your NaOH. Now, what I will do, the next step would be there, mixing. So what I will do, I will take the acid HCl and I will mix into this NaOH and mix it and then I will fill it, just dip the thermometer into it. A little bit of stirring is needed and I will see the rise in temperature, and that would be my T4. Rise in temperature would be T4. So now you can see it is exceeding 31.5. So 31.5, even 32 also I'm going 32 also. So this is 32. Okay, so this is my T4. T3 I got 29.5 and this is my 32. So if I subtract, so you can see 3.5 ka difference that would be there, and that is your delta T. So once you get the delta T, that is 3.5 around, you will put in the formula and further calculation you can see from the manual it is given. So the basic part is there, we have to measure the temperature thrice, first with 50 ml of HCl, then 50 ml of NaOH, and then we will mix and then we will take the temperature. So after mixing, whatever the elevation is coming, that is the very important part, and that we got 3.5. So this we are going to put in the formula and we will get the answer. And always remember that this is the neutralization exothermic reaction. So whatever the answer you will be getting, it should be in the negative sign. Negative sign has to be there, because heat is eliminated or it is released from the system to the surrounding, as you are aware in the thermodynamic. Okay? So this thing you have to take care. I will see the next experiment, that would be displacement 1, copper and zinc in the next class. Thank you.